Okay guys, today in this video, we are currently at Walmart. We've got Amanda in the car since we're in Texas. We're just outside of Dallas. We're actually in Frisco. We're about to unload the Helcota and go over to a car event. And we're gonna go meet up with Jason, Kyle Tingle, and Asher Decker. So they've all got really fast Rams. We're gonna go over to the car show. We'll see what else we get into. Let's unload. Oh, here she is, boys. The Mr. Gasket straps have been holding this thing rock steady for thousands of miles. I have never had to adjust this thing once, you guys. So if you want to check out those straps, I'll link them down below. But yeah, I've never had to adjust this thing anywhere. We've gone over some super rough terrain. You know, not my choice, but just the way it is when you're traveling that far. There's some pretty bumpy roads and construction and all that stuff, and she stayed rock steady. So definitely good straps. I'm gonna go ahead and we'll get this thing out of here, unstrap it, and we'll get into some fun stuff. You ready?
Yes.
There we go, we got her out. So, it does have that slight thing that I gotta resolve. I don't think it's the battery. It's a not a charging issue, but a wiring issue. So I'm gonna have to resolve that once I get back. I'm pretty sure I know what it is. I was talking with the guys at Detroit Speed, but when it's hot, and that's when the starter motor, you know, needs the most juice, that's where I'm having the issue. So I'll explain more later, but just trying to leave it running as much as possible, or if I do turn it off, kind of almost have to let it cool before it'll really want to start. Okay guys, so we're out here, we're at Industrial Cigar Co. Got the Helcota lined up. I'll show you guys some of these cars. This is Jason's, I can't even remember the name of it. This thing looks crazy. He picked this up. You guys have probably seen him on the channel before. He has that huge single turbo, single cab, fourth gen Ram. But he picked up this thing a little while ago, but I'm gonna get inside it and I'll get him to talk more about the details here shortly. But we're out here, we got a bunch of cool cars, Ford GT, RT10, there's an ACR Viper over there. And then I just saw another ACR just roll past, I don't know where he parked. But quite a few Vipers here, but we'll take a little tour and see what's here. So not just a regular Ford GT, she's got a little sauce under there. It's got a blower, looking pretty good. And then let me show you a couple Vipers over here. So we've got an RT10, and this is what we need in the garage. This is what I'm gonna ultimately get. I don't know if it's gonna be a wrecked one that we'll fix, or if I'll get a clean one. They're just skyrocketing in value, but I need one of these in the garage, boys. Right next to our OG ACR. This thing is badass. There's one more over there too, and I'll show you guys that one a little more thoroughly in a second. But if you guys don't know, pretty much every single of these cars are one of one. So when you would originally order one of these, you could order any color you wanted. They would paint it literally any color. And you could pick your combo of stripes, what kind of stripes you wanted, what color you wanted the stripes. So it's very rare you'll see more than one the same color in the ACR. It's pretty cool. But I really like this, you guys. It looks so good. GT500.
It's a stripe.
That's a stain?
A stain.
Stain.
I call them stains.
You call it a stain?
Stain.
Don't tell him you call it a stain.
Shelby. Yeah, I used to have a Mustang. That was like my first one.
Look at the size of brakes on that thing. He's got some wheels in the back that aren't rolling around either. All right, here's the other ACR, you guys. Kind of like a wine looking color. It's got the same color silver stripes as ours. I think I'm more a fan of the traditional red, but it still looks really good. And this wing is huge. You don't see these too often, but they're still pretty cool. So this is a newer NSX. If you guys don't already know, it's a hybrid. So I don't know exactly how much horsepower and all that stuff, but I know it's pretty quick. But these, for some reason, these really didn't do too well as far as sales. But they are a nice car, but the price tag is kind of what killed the sales on these things. I think they priced it like over 200,000, and most people aren't willing to pay that for an Acura, but still a nice car. Look at them horns.
Stop.
You know we're in Texas. Look at it, he's got the tips on the back. They're just as big as the horns. All right, so we got a couple of C8s. You guys have all seen those before. And then we start to get into our Ram Hemi crew. So I'll probably be doing some videos in the next few days on all these trucks at the track and stuff, because a bunch of them are coming with us. This is Asher's truck. You guys saw this one before, so it didn't have a supercharger on it. Now he's got a pro charger on it, as you can see. Got some cool stuff going on here. So I believe Asher's coming to the track with us on Sunday. These. They are like gutted out. So I got the little Braille battery in there too. I'll get them to talk more about the specs on everything they've done if they want to talk about it. But yeah, so we're gonna end up having a single cab Ram here soon again, you guys. Oh look, even the HVAC box is all gone too. She's like gutted right out. But we'll have one on the channel pretty soon and we'll end up doing some stuff to it and Hellcat swap it. So that's gonna be our next project, is pretty much what you see here. Looking stock, but still real nice, you guys. Red eye, wide body, plum crazy. I'm down with it. Nice little GT350. And let's see under the hood of this thing, GT500. Damn, that looks real good. So it definitely doesn't look stock. I see a throttle body and some different stuff. She probably moves out. This thing is clean though. Even the interior. Thing's awesome. A couple GTRs. Also don't look stock, so you don't want to sleep on these guys either. Check this thing out. Well, Jason, what is this thing?
Dude, it's a 2021 US Legend.
2020, it's brand new?
Yeah, brand new.
How much? Are you allowed to say how much you got it for? Off camera?
They're not like super expensive, but they're not like super cheap.
Oh, jeez. That's how YouTube videos start.
Yeah, man. Good video. Yeah, it's got a Yamaha FZ09 engine in it.
What CC is that?
900cc.
What's it out of?
Yamaha FZ09.
Is that a bike?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah.
And then up there, INEX Legends is actually what it's called. They put a custom ECU in them, and they're about 135 horsepower or so.
Well, what's this thing weigh?
1,000 pounds.
Jeez.
Just over 1,000 pounds.
Let me see this thing. How do you get in it? Oh. This thing is crazy. It's so cool. Imagine ripping in this thing. This thing is awesome, you guys. Imagine ripping a road course in this thing. It's got the Wilwood proportioning valve sitting here. It's got little Hoosier tires on it. It's got a little 900cc Yamaha engine. This thing was ripped. This sign is so epic. We believe you when you say your car is fast. Please don't spoil the fun for everyone by doing Mustang things when you leave the parking lot. Ear pierced. Once over on the truck before tomorrow, and I'm putting some miles on it for that differential as well.
So hopefully you guys can hear me. It's a little bit noisy, but we're gonna go over to Jason's little shop here and check out the health quota, just kind of go over everything and make sure she's good for tomorrow.
Well, we're out here at Jason's storage unit. We're gonna go over the truck and see, make sure everything's good. This is his beast. You might have seen some World Star videos on this truck. Might have had a professional driver in Mexico going against the bike. But he's doing a few things to it. He's putting a Hellcat transmission in it. This is the Hellcat one. Yeah, that's the Hellcat one. The 8HP90, he took out the 70 over there to go with his big single turbo. But I'll link that video above here if you guys haven't seen that. You can see his whole setup as well.
Has he got brakes?
We just let him go right in the RV.
Here she is out in the light, guys. Definitely a sick looking unit. We'll have to follow up once he gets her running again. Look at this thing. Look at this thing.
Garbage truck.
It's a big garbage truck turbo on there. Man, this thing is badass, you guys. So again, I have a video on this whole setup and him talking about the whole kit and everything he's got going on there. Definitely want to check that one out if you haven't seen it. So we're gonna go ahead and put this in, see what's up, and make sure she's good to go for tomorrow. All right, so we made some room. We're gonna move this in if Jason lets us.
Come on.
He's gonna let us? All right, let's go. What are we doing, Jason? Tell the people. Tell the people what they want us to hear.
Get the shim out.
So we were just looking. We went for a little rip and found a vibration. And
pinion angle's off a little bit. So
he's got his angle gauge, and looks like the Beltec shim needs to come out to give us a better pinion angle here.
Yeah, it's just all off.
So she's out. There's the other one out. Okay, so we got the Dakota back on the ground, but we took out those shims, but we still need like a 1 degree shim. So we're actually gonna go to Summit tomorrow. Today's Saturday, tomorrow's Sunday. We're gonna try to go to Summit tomorrow in the morning, pick up those shims, because it shows that they have them in stock. We need a 1 degree shim. So we just put Jason's truck back in here. We're gonna put his little dragster thing in here. I guess, he didn't get to drive it just yet, but it's got like a 350 in it. I guess the transmission went out of it, but he got this thing for $500. Pretty cool. So yeah, we're gonna pack up tonight. We're gonna head back, load up the truck, and then we'll come back tomorrow. All right, so we got the Dakota back. We're gonna put it back in the trailer. I just parked the trailer here at our favorite place, Walmart, for the day. While we went over the cars and coffee. But good news is the truck worked awesome all day. There's a few little bugs we got to work out. I'm getting a bit of a driveline vibration when, you know, you really start to get on it. But other than that, I mean, I was able to drive it all over the place and stuff like that. So it's good that it at least works. Seems, you know, somewhat good and steady. So no leaks, nothing weird. And we'll put it in the trailer. And then I will catch you guys in the morning. We're going to head over to Summit and get that part. And we'll probably tinker with the truck over with Jason over at his little shop there, and I'll see you in the morning.